KSR3's Brian Hickey has been following the activity all morning long in Grass Valley. He has an update for us. Good morning, Brian.
Yeah, good morning, guys. It's just one of two helicopters we've seen coming and going from PG&E this morning. Obviously, this one coming in right now to pick up more crews. They're literally flying crews and surveyors into the forests around Grass Valley and Nevada City to figure out exactly where those lines went down yesterday, lines that have left more than 10,000 people without power. As that helicopter sits down in the PG&E yard, look over here. We're in the grocery store parking lot, and they're using this as a staging area as well, where PG&E crews are gearing up and getting ready to head out onto the mountain to and the town to go out and repair so many power lines that came down yesterday in the ice and snow. Take a look at this video we shot on the way into Grass Valley this morning. Coming up Highway 49, we passed an army of PG&E crews coming into town, and this is what they're coming to fix. See these power lines down? This is right in the heart of Nevada City, the historic park. They're right off of Park Avenue, and you can see just a major line that was down, brought down by a huge tree. And getting to these downed lines, it's going to be a challenge today. All of the snow that fell yesterday has turned into crunchy ice and just very slick conditions. We ran into these folks here at the Beach Hut Deli. We heard the sound of a generator, went down the street, and they were in there making sandwiches at 4:30 this morning. Not because they expected a lot of customers. They expected one, the PG&E crews that they hope will be putting their power back on today.
We're making 140 sandwiches for PG&E.
Under what conditions?
No electricity. And we're freezing. It's not fun.
And they're not the only thing freezing here in Nevada City. Back out here live, take a look at the parking lot. Again, that is a sheet of ice, and many of the roads around town this morning are in that very similar condition. A little bit of melt from yesterday. It all froze overnight in 20-degree temperatures, and hopefully the residents are faring okay as well, because, again, temperatures down in the 20s. A lot of them did not have heat last night as they're waiting for their power to come back on, and it was just a frigid morning. Fortunately, right now, the sun is out, the skies are blue, and those utility crews will have good conditions to go out and make those repairs. Live in Grass Valley, I'm Brian Hickey. Back to you.